All right, y'all, TCV, the country boy, coming back at you from Big D. You know, there's this song, and I'm a little confused by it, and I've been confused by this particular song for years, and I bet some of you rock and roll aficionados from the 70s or whatever can tell me, man, this song scares the shit out of me, man. I play it on the drums quite often because it's a hell of a song to play drums to, but this is a song that was done by Blue Oyster Cult, which is a rock group, back in 1981. And the name of this song is called Burning For You. And man, I've always thought that this song was kind of like a devil worship song or whatever, man. I don't know. I just had this bad feeling that I didn't know, was it a Christian song? Was it a devil worship song? But I mean, Blue Oyster Cult, I remember that song they did, Don't Fear the Reaper or something like that, but that song kind of freaked me out too. That was one of their top songs. But you know, this is the first time I really thought about it, and I still play the drums to it. But sometimes I stop myself from playing drums to it for a while because I think it's sacrilegious. You know, it's not cool to be doing it. But if that was the case, man, and pretty much every damn song would be, if you know what I mean. But anyway, this song was written by Donald Roser, who was the lead guitarist in Blue Oyster Cult. And then he went by Buck Dharma, is what his stage name was or whatever. But he was around since the formation of Blue Oyster Cult, the band, back in 1967. He wrote and sang vocals. And he also wrote Dear Don't Fear the Reaper. But he wrote this song with a dude named Richard Metzler. And I think Richard Metzler came up with a lot of these lyrics from what I read before. And this guy was like a rock critic and stuff like that. But I did a little research, and I'm doing a little research on this, and I'm looking up a couple of articles that say, you know, and my question that I have, man, is this like devil worshiping song or not? I don't know, man. Here's what it says on a particular website called lyricinterpretations.com. And it says here, clearly this song is about a musician, probably Dharma himself. But I thought a lot of the words were written by this Richard Metzler guy. But it says here, it's about someone selling his soul to the devil in trade for becoming a famous musician. It says words like, I can't see no reason to put up a fight. I'm living for giving the devil his due. Means that he's already made the deal. No reason to fight. He's just giving the devil his due. Time everlasting. Time to play B-sides. Time ain't on my side. Time I'll never know. Means that there will be a time for B-sides, but he will write A-side music now. I'm burning, I'm burning, I'm burning for you. Is telling the fans to bring you this music, he will someday burn in hell for you. No other way can possibly be interpreted. You know, I've always had the feeling that this was kind of a song that was not on the cool side. I mean, especially when it says, I'm living for giving the devil his due. I was trying to think, you know, I remember playing it in my head or playing it on the drums, and I was trying to think of it from a song on the Jesus side, you know. I'm living to give the devil his due, meaning he's going straight to hell or whatever. But I don't know, man. Y'all tell me. People that know this Blue Oyster Cult, have y'all read anything, or do y'all hear anything, or have y'all heard anything in the past? I'd kind of like to put this to rest. Is this song a devil worshiping song? Is it a Christian song? Or is it just a song that they put out there as fluff to kind of freak people out? I don't know. You tell me. Do you know? But anyway, I'm going to play this song now. I want y'all to check it out. It is a rocking song, man. You got to admit, it is a badass song. So check this out. Here we go. Okay. Wow. I don't know, man. I don't know. Blue Oyster Cult. I mean, I don't know if anybody would ever want to be a cult for a blue oyster, but I don't know, man. Maybe they're rare. I don't know. Wow. I don't know, man. Is this song a devil worshipping song or not? Is that group or is that band? I don't know, man. Golly, I don't know. I got the sneaking suspicion I probably should not play the song anymore on drums, but what do I know? Wow. I mean, that opens up a whole bunch of questions, you know? Is music today full of, you know? I don't know, man. I don't know. I don't know. You tell me. All right, y'all. I'll see y'all later. Creepy. All right, y'all. TCV, the country boy, coming back at you from Big D. What's happening, everybody? I just want to let y'all know that if y'all do know of somebody that's got a house that needs some work and they want to get rid of it, they don't want to mess with it anymore, let us know. Let us know who those people are. Get us in contact with them. If we buy the house, I'll give you $1,000, man. Simple as that. Just for the hookup of knowing somebody that's got a house that they want to get rid of, man. Anywhere in the United States, as long as it's a decent, livable neighborhood, and you know, we don't get killed going over there trying to fix it up or whatever. But I'm just saying, you know what I'm saying? So we can do some business and some fun at the same time. So there you go, y'all. I appreciate it.